What do an Aston Martin supercar, a Romanesco broccoli, and the pyramids of Giza have in common with each other? Well, upon first glance, nothing much, right? But when we look at these seemingly unrelated objects through a different viewpoint, we see that they all have one deeper similarity. Wait, hold up. Am I saying that pine cones, nautilus shells, and the Mona Lisa have something in common? Well, yes. Yes, I am. A deeper similarity in that aesthetic device, which they use to look so beautiful to us today. Studies in neuroscience have shown that our brains tend to process symmetrical stimuli more efficiently. It seems that symmetrical images and symmetrical buildings are simply easier for our brains to process, as seen in a study by Makin et al. In 2016, where participants' brains responded positively to symmetrical stimuli. Now, they say beauty is in the eyes of the beholders. Well, all the examples I've given you today, from the Mona Lisa to the pyramids of Giza, are examples of beauty which is seen as beautiful by everyone, by all the beholders in the world. Me, you all, and everyone in the universe. Way back in fourth grade, I had enrolled myself in a competition. A competition to create a model skyscraper, one which would wow the judges, the beholders of this competition, with its aesthetical looks. I knew about an aesthetic device which would set my design to the next level. And with a blend of creativity and flair, I had created a model which didn't just catch the eye, it dazzled the judges. I had harnessed this device to the best of my abilities, and had created a model that looked just about perfect. I had created a model skyscraper, incorporating a special kind of rectangle in each pane of paper used. It wasn't any ordinary rectangle. This rectangle had sides set in a fixed yet constant ratio. The secret to my success? An architectural vision that transformed my simple idea into an architectural masterpiece. Nowadays, when we look at all the buildings and metropolitan cities all around us, we see that they all have one desire. I mean, we all have desires, don't we? My desire is for all of you to love this talk and to get something out of it. But the underlying desire or urge, you could say, of these metropolitan cities is to have a cityscape that stands out. Now, we're living in a world where there's a need for so many buildings. And we need those buildings to stand out. So that's exactly what the architects of today are doing. They're creating buildings and cityscapes which are unique. But does looking unique mean the same thing as looking beautiful? Or dare I say, aesthetic? The walkie-talkie building is a prime example of this statement. This building in London has a weird design. It grows taller and wider as it goes up. Its top-heavy nature evokes emotions of greed in the eyes of the beholders. That's not a good thing, is it? The Carbuncle Cup is an award given annually to the worst building in the world, the ugliest building in the world. And it was bestowed upon the walkie-talkie building in 2016. Yes, you heard me right. This building was crowned as the world's ugliest building. The concave glass present in this building would focus the sun's rays onto the city's streets, creating high temperatures. And by high temperatures, I don't just mean temperatures that are high. I mean, like, really hot. You could cook an omelet on the street. Believe me, it's been tested before. Now, I'm going to ask all of you a simple question. Don't worry, it's not that hard. I want you to look at the screen and pick your favorite rectangle. There's so many different rectangles, right? But is there one rectangle which stands out? One which looks the most aesthetically pleasing? Well, I'm going to go on a whim here. I'll make a prediction and say that most of you will choose the rectangle in the center. Well, I mean, it's just my prediction, okay? Don't sue me if I'm wrong. In the 1860s, a psychologist by the name of Gustav Fichtner presented his subjects with an array of varying rectangles, much like I've done with you today. He then asked them, which one was their favorite? and he found out that a staggering 76% of all the entries chose one rectangle. And that rectangle was the rectangle in the center. And this was no just ordinary rectangle. It had sides set in a simple yet fixed ratio. And what was this ratio, you may be asking? The golden ratio. Mathematically, the ratio of 1 is to 1.618. This is the device that we can use today to shape our future for a better tomorrow. A building commonly seen in nature, as well as having a great coherence with it. The golden ratio is always seen throughout nature, as well as in buildings all around us. Buildings such as the Burj Khalifa in Dubai, as well as the Guggenheim Museum in New York, are prime examples of how a ratio so old can be used to create buildings so new, which resonate with the viewers today. The Taj Mahal, a mausoleum located in Agra, India, is a prime example of this. This building is world-renowned for how beautiful and mesmerizing it looks, and it incorporates golden proportions in the ratio of its grand central arch, as well as the ratio of the windows within that arch. The Dubai frame is literally what its name suggests, a giant golden frame positioned in the heart of Dubai city. Frames are in the shape of what? In the shape of a rectangle, right? But as you may have guessed, we're not talking about any other rectangle. We're talking about a specific rectangle, the golden rectangle. Once again, a rectangle with sides set in a ratio, which is fixed and constant, of 1 is to 1.618. This building is a major reason of why people even go to Dubai in the first place. Have you heard of the ancient Greek Pantheon? It's a Greek building designed to honor the Greek gods. But it turns out, it honors so much more than just the Greek gods. It honors the guiding principles of the golden ratio in architecture. It's as if all the architects throughout the world in all the generations knew about this ancient ratio. And so they used it in their architectural creations to take them to the next level. So many buildings which we perceive as beautiful today are ones which have been created using the golden ratio. The golden ratio is also seen widely in the seven wonders of the world. We've already been over the Taj Mahal, but even wonders such as the ancient pyramids of Giza in Egypt, as well as the Christ the Redeemer statue in Rio de Janeiro, incorporate the golden ratio a lot in their designs. The Guggenheim Museum, when introduced in New York in the late 1900s, has been controversial, yes, but now it has grown to become a landmark of the New York City skyline. Designed by a world-famous architect, Frank Lloyd Wright, this building has grown to become a beautiful symbol of the New York City skyline, incorporating the golden ratio everywhere, and I mean everywhere. The Sydney Opera House is another building which is world-renowned for its coherence with nature. And it's no surprise that it has a surprising coherence with the golden ratio as well. This building has been known to resonate in the eyes of the viewers. And I'm sure all of you, just looking at it right now, I'm sure it resonates in your mind right now, doesn't it? The golden ratio has been the guiding light behind so many of the architectural creations around us. From the symmetry of the buildings of the Renaissance to the layouts of modern cities all around us, the golden ratio has been a quiet way in changing how we perceive beauty all around us. It's amazing to see that to create a future that we are part of, we don't have to think up radical new ideas. A simple step into the past will do. A step into the past reveals the golden ratio, a device from yesterday that we can use today to create a future which we are proud of to be a part of tomorrow. Thank you.